बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन। आई होप यू ऑल विल बी फाइन। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वेलकम टू माय चैनल, एंड सेकेंडली मैं ये बता दूँ कि इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट और इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव शेयर्ड एवरीथिंग अबाउट द लिटरेरी टर्म्स एंड द विच काइंड ऑफ पोइम इज़ दिस इन द वीडियो। सो आज की वीडियो इज़ अ कम्प्लीट डिस्क्रिप्शन अबाउट पोइम ऑन हिज ब्लाइंडनेस बाई जॉन मिल्टन। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। When I consider how my light is spent, now यहाँ पर light के दो मतलब हैं। सबसे पहला मतलब है कि poet light को अपनी life के साथ मिला रहा है। Secondly, इसका ये मतलब है कि उसके पास देखने के लिए कितना वक्त रह गया है। Light means the time he has left to see, and other meaning is his life. So in this line, the poet is thinking of how he is spending his time. Ere half my days in this dark world and white. Ere means before. Dark world means that he is blind, and white world means that in darkness everything seems to be endless. And there is alliteration that is used in world and white. In this line, the poet is thinking that how he has spent his life before his blindness, now he is spending his life in the days in darkness. And that one talent which is death to hide. He was given a talent of writing, so he cannot write because he is blind. Lost with me useless, though my soul more bent. Lost means that he is stuck with his talent, and the talent of writing poetry now is useless because the poet cannot see. And soul more bent means that his soul now seems determined to use this talent. To serve therewith my maker and present. He wants to use his talent to serve his maker, and maker means God, and he present means that he wants to give something to God. My true account lest he returning chide. True account means his good works, and chide means to criticize something, and he did not use his talent and now he is worried that God criticize him. Doth God exact day labor denied. It can be paraphrased as, does God demand that which cannot be given? So, how can God expect him to work a full day if he withholds his eyesight? Or the poet suddenly wonders if God is unfair in expecting him to make something of his talent when he is blind. I fondly ask, but patience, to prevent that murmur soon replies. Patient is there not a personal trait of the poet, rather God's Holy Spirit, and it personifies it and having it answer Milton's question. There is a personification of virtue, that means patience, and he answers himself to prevent or to stop the complaint from reaching God, to protect the poet. God doth not need either man's work or his own gifts. This line is simple, that means that God doesn't need anything from man, as he does not need work or gift because he has given you talents. Who best bear his mild yoke, they serve him best. Mild yoke means burden or God's will. And the people who are most respectful to God's will are the ones who serve God best. These are the people who endure their misfortunes without complaining. So if the poet accepts his blindness and copes with it, he serves God well, according to him. His state is kingly, thousands at his bidding speed, and post over land and ocean without rest. They also serve who stand and wait. It means that the whole world are servants to God, and there is more than one way to serve God, and patience is telling the poet that even his waiting caused by his blindness can be a kind service to God. So coming towards the summary, in this sonnet the speaker mediates on the fact that he has become blind. He expresses his frustration at being prevented by his disability from serving God as well as he desires to. He is answered by patience, who tells him that God has many who hurry to do his bidding and does not really need man's work. So, as the famous last line sums it up, that they also serve who only stand and wait. This was all about the poem on his blindness. If you have any kind of question, you can state this in the comment section. And thank you so much for watching my video.